Good morning.
Good morning.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to St. Peter's United Church of Christ. I'm Pastor Nicole, and it is wonderful to have you all with us this morning. Please take a moment and sign the friendship pads that are on the inside of the aisle. They're the black pads, and pass them on through. It's always good to see who's with us, especially when we're celebrating confirmations. I have some news to share with you, because it's been quite a week, right? So Robert Horse passed away last night. And there'll be more information coming. Oh wait, no, Robert Horse was last week. There's no funeral. Don Anderson passed away, and we'll have more information coming for him as well. And Ken Dietering also passed away. Ken Dietering's funeral will be April 27th at Bethel at 2:30. But I don't have information for Don Anderson yet. So that's three beloved members, well, two members and a good friend of the church who have all passed away this week. So you will get an email, members, you will get an email when we have information coming so that you know when the funerals are so you can come and join us. Today is confirmation, and before you leave, if you go into the lounge, there's that little, I don't have a word for it, nook by the windows, and there are faith projects that our eighth grade confirmands made to kind of share their faith and how they're journeying with it. So please take a moment today and check them out, because when our confirmands leave today, they can take their faith projects home so that they get to enjoy them for the rest of their lives. So check them out, because it's something worth seeing. Are there any other announcements for the good of the community? Seeing none, let's prepare our hearts and our minds for worship.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung, and may you stay. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of change shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be we sung, and may you stay.
Please stand and join me in the call to worship. This is the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and celebrate.
Today we worship, celebrating Christ's return to God.
We look up with wonder as Jesus is lifted to heaven.
There is work that is yet to be done. Let us go and serve God.
Let us prepare our hearts for the task ahead with prayer and grace.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Please pray with me. God of incredible surprises, as we look up at the clouds, remind us that our feet are standing on holy ground. Guide our steps on paths of peace and hope. Move our attention from the heavens to focus on the ministry of being the body of Christ with our feet on the ground. Keep our hearts ready and willing to serve you in all our days. Amen. Part of our worship includes sharing our humanity with one another. In the world, we put on a strong face that acts like we've got it all together. But here in worship, we remember that we're all human beings. We all make mistakes. We all fall short, and we give it to God so that we can get back up. Please join me. Forgiving God, you called us to be the church as we live our resurrection faith. You asked us to share the good news of your steadfast love in word and deed, but we remain still. Our faith gets saved for a Sunday morning, while we hear the constant noise of the world. We feel our lives getting overfull, becoming too busy to help others. We look for the quick self-help fixes that leave us feeling empty and alone. Forgive us for the smallness of our faith. Clear our spirits of the clutter from daily living. Help us make space to grow in our faith, building healthy relationships with you, O God, and one another. Spirit, challenge us to move in directions that provide peace and hope to all people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God loves us and forgives us, that we might share those blessings with others. You are called to be messengers of God's good news to all people. Go and serve in that love. Amen. Let us join our hearts and our voices together as we sing, "Here I Am, Lord," number 559 in your hymnal.
Thank you.
may be seated.
The kingship of God is the centerpiece of this psalm. It's a reminder that God rules over all earth, above all nations and people. Let us join our voices in reading Psalm 47 responsively. People everywhere, clap your hands, shout to God with a joyful voice.
For Yahweh Most High is awe-inspiring, the great ruler over the whole earth.
God subdues peoples for us and puts the nation under our feet.
God chooses our inheritance for us, the pride of Leah, Rachel, and Jacob, the object of God's love.
God ascended the throne with a shout, with trumpet blasts.
Sing praise to God. Sing praise. Sing praise to our ruler. Sing praise.
For God rules over all the earth. Sing praise and understand.
God rules over the nations. God sits on the throne of holiness.
World leaders are gathered, and so are the people of Sarah and Abraham, God's. For Yahweh reigns over all the earth and is exalted above all.
Thank you, Kaylee. Our New Testament reading this morning comes from Acts chapter 1, verses 1 through 11. Listen. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and teach until the day when he was taken up to heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard of from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom of Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know the time or the periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in Samaria, and the ends of the earth. When he said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you to heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. Thanks be to God for the hearing of this word. Amen.
Thank you. This morning, there are four congregations that are commissioning adults to head to Kentucky. I'd like to invite our adults from our congregation, Fitz Fitzpatrick, Nancy Petzold, Alan Utek, Paula DeSmit, and Jean Dietering to please come forward. You can see the other names of those being commissioned in your bulletin. Come closer. It's easier to get you on the screen. Hello, friends. I don't bite. Excellent. Today, we commission those who have been called to serve with the Kentucky United Church of Christ Disaster Relief. This team is responding to the tornado that hit December 11th, 2021, and was followed by a flood in January of 2022. Will you accept this commission and live it out to the best of your abilities? Will you strive to love God with all your heart, soul, strength, and mind, and to love your neighbor as yourself? If so, please respond, we will. As you serve next week, will you seek to grow in love for God and neighbor, promising to support each other and the staff, including Reverend Greg Denk, being the body of Christ in action? If so, please answer, we will. As you travel, will you live into the promise of the good news, sharing the love of Christ with all people? If so, please answer, we will. Now, this is all of us. People of God, will you support these persons who God has called to serve with the Kentucky UCC Disaster Relief? Will you pray for them, encourage them, and send them as ambassadors of Christ and representatives of our United Church of Christ community? If so, please answer, we will.
We will.
Please pray with me. God of love, we pray for safety as our team travels, courage as they have new experiences, and excitement as they grow in their faith in you. Help them embrace all people as their neighbors. Bless them with hearts that serve, so they may share the strength of your love with each other. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, amen. Will you please give them a hand as they head back to their seats? I'd like to invite our children and young people to come forward and to join me on the steps. Good morning, good morning. Good morning, friends. How are you? Good? Some of you are having to sit a whole lot closer than you normally sit. How does it feel? No spit? No spit. A little intimidating? Come on over. There's room. There's room. Good morning. So what did we do last week? Do you remember? It's kind of a big deal. There were flowers, there was music, there was baskets, there were plastic eggs everywhere. Easter! I thought we forgot. That went quick. So today we've got a big service, right? I want you to look around. So we just had a commissioning, right? And next we'll have, later we'll have confirmation. And then what do you see over there? Communion. That's three big things in a service, right? So who knows what it means to commission people? What does it mean to commission? Yes. Ooh, I love your definition, Chloe. To send them on their way with good things. Yeah. It means that all of us authorize those adults and the people who are going with them to go and serve in Kentucky, and that they agreed, they're committed to go and serve on behalf of God and all of us, right? That's kind of a big deal to say yes to that, right? We haven't done that in a while. Okay, what does confirm mean? What do you think it means to confirm? Confirm. Do you know what affirm means? Affirm is to be like, yes, we agree. To confirm means that our eighth graders who did confirmation class, right? They are confirming, they are saying yes to their faith that their parents did when their parents baptized them when they were babies, right? So that's why the baptismal font is here, because when we do baptisms, we tend to do children and babies, right? And we say that we will raise them so that they grow in faith and love here in church, right? We're giving them to God. And now they're saying, listen, this is our faith. This is our faith. And they become members of St. Peter's United Church of Christ. That's what we're doing. So that's why we have the baptismal font here, because they're going to kneel in front of it and put their hands on the baptismal font and say, this is my faith now. My parents blessed me when I was a child, and now I'm taking it on. It is mine. Who knows what it means to bless people? What does it mean to bless someone? If I sneeze, what would you say?
Bless you.
Bless you. You would say bless you, see? It means you're asking God's protection and care to be with somebody, right? And you're saying, this is holy. You're holy and you matter. So when we did the commissioning, that was a blessing for the adults. When we do the confirmation, people are going to lay their hands on our confirmands and we'll be saying, we're blessing you. We want to bless your life and let you know we want God to go with you and for you to know that you're loved always, right? Even when you're not with us. And there's something about being at the table together when we're all having communion later that is also a blessing, a reminder that we belong to one another, right? That's part of being Christian. It's not something we do by ourselves. It's something we do as a community. Now, before we pray, I want to clarify something, and it's kind of important, okay? So we have the eighth graders over here, right? And they're getting confirmed. If you have a sibling or a cousin or a friend who's getting confirmed, would you raise your hand if it's one of yours? Okay, you have some choices, okay, friends? I know there's Sunday school downstairs, but it's also really good for you to be up here blessing your family, okay? So if you would like to stay up here to be part of the blessing, you are welcome to do that, all right? Can I ask, who's your person? Emma's your person. Who's your person? Molly, who's your person? Weston? Maverick's your person, yes. Parker, yes. Parker, there's a lot of love up here, right? So I invite you to stay up and bless them, okay? Because there's going to be a part where I say, if you are family or friends of Parker, would you come up and lay hands on him, okay? And you are welcome to come up for that, okay? Does that make sense? And if you think it's going to be really long and no thank you, you are also welcome to go downstairs for Sunday school. Does that make sense? You have choices. Could you pray with me? Bow your heads. God, thank you so much for the blessing of being the body of Christ. We give thanks for our time together and the examples of faith that are before us today. Reminders that we don't have to be perfect, but our faith trusts and hopes in Jesus Christ, and that is enough. Please bless Sunday school teachers and bless the families and friends of all who are gathered. In Jesus' name we pray, and the people say,
Amen.
Amen. Okay, there's treats, friends. If you grab Sour Patch Kids or jelly beans, you can grab two. Otherwise, just one. And then you can go wherever you're going, Sunday school or back by your families or into the choir or all the things. You can grab two of those. Yep. You can grab two if you get the Sour Patch Kids or the jelly beans. You get two. What would you like, hon? You can have two. You can have two. You grab jelly beans. You can have two. Go ahead. Grab one more and then go sit. Go ahead. All right.
The next part means we're going to open and make a lot of noise at one time. So everybody open your treats, please. And let's get them all opened up so you can snack, because the pastor talks a little bit. All right? Grace to you and peace which comes from Jesus Christ, our risen Savior. Amen. Today is a full Sunday when we commission an adult team to go to Kentucky, confirm the new eighth grade members into the congregation, and come to the communion table as a community of faith. It is fitting that the week after Easter we would be in chapter 1 of Acts. Being the church, being Christian, is not an independent project. Jesus spent 40 days after Easter with the disciples, proving himself to them and teaching them before he ascended into heaven. He let his followers know that they would be baptized with the Holy Spirit and that they would go and be his witnesses. It's a heavy gift, really. The reality that you are going to receive the Holy Spirit as a gift and then need to witness to Jesus Christ. This is what we are continuing to celebrate today, the gifts of the Holy Spirit at work all around us and being witnesses to our faith in Jesus Christ. Look again at the people we commissioned, or ahead of you to the confirmands who are about to affirm their faith for themselves. Each of these people have different gifts and abilities to use, yet each of them heard the call, the invitation to follow Jesus, and they said yes. Life is easier when we can look up at the sky, waiting for Jesus' return, but for 2,000 years, Christians have been waiting. We wait for Jesus to return and make things right. And we also hear Jesus telling us that we are his witnesses. It's an interesting dynamic, one that is not so quiet as it reminds us to be where our feet are. To be where our feet are means that we have work to do right here, right now. We have different gifts that we can use to do that work. However, if we are only looking ahead, then we aren't really present in this moment. And we aren't going to respond. Part of me celebrates this, while the other part of me thinks, oof, have mercy. There are a lot of people more talented than I am. They are more qualified than I am. You know what, though? Every other person thinks that, too. We look up and say, God, what are you going to do? There are so many needs in the world right now. People are hungry and lonely. There are those who are ill. We look up to heavens and ask God, why aren't you doing something? And Jesus looks back at us and says, he did. He created you, and you have been baptized with the Holy Spirit. So go. Be where your feet are and do something. This idea of waiting for heaven wasn't the plan. Jesus repeatedly talked about the kingdom of God being at hand, being right here and present. We are to do the work for God's kingdom come here and now, not wait for Jesus to come back and do it himself, or pray that if we're really good, we'll get into heaven, but to start the work today. This morning, we bless one another. We bless those who heard the need in Kentucky to repair homes that were damaged by a tornado and flooding. The insurance companies already did their part. They bought supplies. The professionals are focused on businesses. But the people who live and work in those areas that were affected have been waiting for help to come to do repairs so that they can continue to live and work in their communities. And adults from four congregations in our area responded, yes, we'll come. We'll do what we can. Send me. You might be looking at our youth this morning and thinking, well, they've got some growing to do yet, and they've already begun to raise their hands and share their gifts. Most of them have gone to St. Louis, and they've seen the wider church in action. Not only did they see where a portion of our offerings go, but they volunteered to serve in each of our church's health and human services ministries that we visited. They read books to children in the inner city. They played bingo with adults with disabilities at Emmaus Homes, and they got their hands dirty gardening at Eden to provide fresh produce to local pantries and food programs. Another youth did their faith project by providing Valentine's packages to 15 people at Rocky Knoll who have no families, and they used their own money as well as reaching out to family and friends for support. Our faith is not meant to be relegated to the 1 hour you're in the pew Sunday morning. Our faith is something people experience in the ways that we treat others, in the ways that we talk and act every day. This is how we witness who Jesus is. Jesus told us that we would be baptized by the Holy Spirit, that we would be witnesses. It wasn't a soundbite that meant to make Jesus' followers feel uncomfortable sitting and watching the sky for Jesus to return. It was a call to action. The way we live our lives tells others what we believe about Jesus. Does Jesus demand power, or does he serve those who are marginalized? Is Jesus one who threatens people, or does he offer forgiveness and welcome and love? The quote at the top of the bulletin today is from Reverend Fred Rogers, also known as Mr. Rogers for those who grew up when I did. It reminds us, we all have different gifts, so we all have different ways of saying to the world who we are. Our gifts also share to the world who God is in the world. Creative, serving, forgiving, present, just, hospitable, genuine, honest, humble, love. In a few minutes, we will gather at Christ's communion table to remember that Jesus served his friends, his disciples at the Last Supper. During that last meal, his words were not threats against the power that was going to kill him. Jesus told his disciples to love one another as I have loved you. By this, they will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. So may we come to the table, ready to participate not only in this meal together, but also ready to participate in being witnesses to Christ's life and resurrection and Christ's love as we leave this place. Remember that you are loved. Go and do likewise. Please pray with me. Steadfast God, our eyes look up, waiting for Jesus to return. Our feet feel planted firmly, thinking that someone else is more qualified than we are to love and serve in Jesus' name. Spirit, move our feet so that we go where Jesus calls us. You ask us to live our faith in service, offering peace and justice, hope and healing to all people we meet. Open our hearts so that we show love in the ways that we care for one another. We lift the names of those who are on our hearts and minds, including Fred Bethke, Arlene Collin, Sue Erdman, Helen Ergen, Jerry Henschel, Corrine Heinz, Jessica Hornick, Jen Yashub, Lynette Kissinger, Thomas Mallory, Brian Potter, Kathy Robb, Michael Schnell, Jessica Summers, and those who go unnamed but remain on our hearts and our minds. We want your healing mercies for all who are ill, for those who are waiting for calls or answers, those who are going through treatment, those who take it one day at a time to the best of their ability, those who are lost and alone. Everlasting God,
Draw near to the family and friends of Ken Dietering, Bob Horst, and Don Anderson as they grieve their passing. We carry with us all the people we love, knowing that you know their needs and are with them. We pray for those who are cleaning up after the earthquake in Taiwan and ask that you continue to be with those who are in countries at war. Protect the peacemakers, the ones providing food, shelter, and care in the midst of it all. We rejoice this morning for the faith of those who commissioned to go to Kentucky next week. God grant your traveling mercies as they go and as they return. We celebrate the growing faith of our confirmands today as they continue their faith journey into the future. We look forward to their opportunities to grow in faith and love and ask your blessing be upon them their whole lives long. Hear us as together we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I invite our confirmands to come forward with their faith mentors so that their faith mentors can introduce them to our congregation. Parker, you're over here. Parker, then Allie, and Weston, Molly, and Annie, Owen, Maverick, and Emma. You're gonna come right over here. Parker, Allie, Weston, Molly, Annie. All right, I'll let you introduce them first. Deep breath.
All right, I have the distinct honor of introducing a wonderful young man. He has passion for farming, enjoys sports, especially basketball. I wonder where he gets that from. Has a deep love for his family. I present for confirmation the son of Kayla and Josh and the best big brother to Amaya and their dog, Bear, Mr. Parker Albert Barden.
I have had the pleasure of being Allie's faith mentor. 1 Peter 3:4 states, "Clothe yourself with the beauty that comes from within, the unfolding beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is so precious to God." Allie shares that attending confirmation has deepened her faith. Everything has deep meaning and importance in making a difference in my spiritual walk with God. Everything is connected in some way. Allie likes St. Peter's Church because everyone knows each other and it feels like family. I enjoyed mentoring Allie. She made my heart sing. She has a bright future ahead. I hope through the sharing of my faith with Allie, I have planted a seed of faith, hope, and love. I end with this message to Allie. The one thing that you have that no one else has is you. Your voice, your mind, your story, your vision. So write and draw and build and play and dance and live as only you can. And as always, keep God close to your heart. I present Allie Endres.
My name is Joanne, and I'd like to introduce you to Weston Healer. I have known Weston since he was born. I've been blessed to remain close to him and his family over the years. I've watched him grow, which I feel like is a lot lately, and I feel it was even more special to see him grow in faith. He is smart, funny, and one of the kindest boys I know. He made it clear during all of our classes that he loves fishing, and it's one of his favorite things to do with his family. He was always willing to read, one of the few to always have his hands raised, and would never let snacks or sweets go to waste. Thank you, Weston, for letting me be part of this journey with you.
I've had the pleasure of knowing this young lady since she was a little girl. Since her family and my daughter's family are close, I saw her at family functions, school functions, here in church, and at school activities. Mike and Joanne can be proud of their daughter. She is well-grounded in her faith and family. As a little sister to Cameron and a big sister to Riley, family memories and activities are her favorite. Her faith is grounded in the bracelet she wears, Philippians 4, verse 13. I can do anything with the help of God. Also, her great-grandma Tess has a strong influence on her. She saw her great-grandma going to church almost every Sunday, and it's her strong faith that has left quite an impression on her. I am honored as a mentor to introduce our new church family member, Molly Ann Yashup.
Today, we get to come together and I get to introduce and celebrate the confirmation of a sweet and beloved soul, Annalee Pero. Annie is a child of God and a cherished daughter of Tina and Eric and a loving sister of Emma. Her journey of faith has brought her to this moment, and we couldn't be happier to witness her commitment and her devotion. Annie has chosen Psalm 23 as her guiding light, finding solace and happiness in its words. The psalm brings her joy, and it serves as a source of strength in times of both triumph and challenge. Annie's song that she chose is Hallelujah, and what a wonderful way to look at the world. Let us offer our prayers, blessing, and support as she continues her journey as this child of God. We congratulate you, Annalee, on this beautiful milestone in your life.
I'd like to introduce to you a remarkable young man, one who has a work ethic that does nothing halfway. He does everything to the best of his ability. He cares about helping others. He lives his faith on a daily basis. I am proud to have been his mentor for these past 2 years. He may not realize it, but he helped me grow in my faith. If you happen to be up at 4:30 in the morning, you'll see him riding his bike around town as he's training. Let me introduce you to my neighbor, Owen Schwantz.
My name is Craig Heeler, and my faith mentee is Maverick Socek. I've been fortunate enough to know Mav as more than just a faith mentor. I first met Mav and his family when my son Weston and Mav played baseball together. During that time, our families have grown close and have been able to witness Mav's growth as a young adult in life and faith firsthand. He's taught my son Weston how to fish the mighty Sheboygan River. As many of you know, that river takes up a lot of the lures. The boys lost a lot of lures. With the guidance of Mav, though, I'm proud to say Weston is down to about one lure a time he goes out. Mav is a great teacher and an even better person. I feel lucky to be his mentor. I cannot wait to see where his faith and life take him. Congratulations, Mav.
Really tall. Hi, I'm Lori, and I'm honored to be able to introduce Emma Thibault, a daughter of Paul and Katie Thibault, sister to Ava, a fourth generation child of God at St. Paul UCC. She is a delightfully curious person who loves to read, play soccer and basketball, go Iowa, and shares my love of horses. She highlighted her relationship with her grandfather, Alan, and her mentor, who models service to others in a way she appreciates. Emma chose James 1, verse 3, for when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. Emma appreciates that at St. Peter's UCC, she is able to develop her own opinions and grow her own relationship with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Emma chose Ode to Joy as her favorite song, which speaks of hope, unity, and fellowship. We are also very proud of her decision to demonstrate her faith in this way. Welcome, Emma.
We are all received into the church through the sacrament of baptism. These youth have found nurture and support in the midst of the family of Christ. Through prayer and study, they have been led by the Holy Spirit to affirm their baptism and to claim in our presence their covenantal relationship with Christ and the members of the church. They are here for service to Jesus Christ using the gifts which the Holy Spirit bestows. Hear the words of Jesus. I am the vine, you are the branches. Anyone who abides in me and I in that person is the one who bears much fruit. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you will, and it shall be done for you. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be full. Confirmands, are you ready? Confirmands, do you desire to affirm your baptism and to be confirmed into the faith and family of Jesus Christ? If so, respond, I do. Do you renounce the powers of evil and desire the freedom of new life in Christ? If so, respond a little louder, I do. Do you profess Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? If so, respond loudly, I do. Do you promise by the grace of God to be Christ's disciples, to follow in the way of our Savior, to resist oppression and evil, to show love and justice, and to witness the work and word of Jesus Christ the best you are able? If so, respond, I promise with the help of God. Do you promise, according to the grace given you, to continue to grow in Christian faith, to be a faithful member of the Church of Jesus Christ, celebrating Christ's presence and furthering Christ's mission in the world? If so, respond, I promise with the help of God. I invite the whole congregation to join their voice and with their voices with our confirmands in affirming the church in all times and places in confession of our faith in God. Repeat after me. I believe in God.
I believe in God.
I believe in Jesus Christ.
I believe
in the Holy Spirit.
I believe in the Holy Spirit.
Please pray with me. Almighty God, who in baptism received these beloved people into the church and forgave their sins, promising eternal life, increase in them the gifts of Holy Spirit. Grant them love for others, joy in serving you, peace in disagreement, patience in suffering, kindness to all people, goodness in evil times, faithfulness in temptation, gentleness in the face of opposition, and self-control in all things. Strengthen our confirmands in their ministry in the world. Through Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. So now we're going to have them complete their confirmation vows. So one at a time we'll have our youth kneel at the altar and have their hands on the baptismal font.
And I invite family and friends who are here, as well as their fellow friends, right, who did confirmation together, to lay their hands on our confirmands so we bless them as they prepare for confirmation. All right? We're going to start with Parker. Parker, are you ready? You're going to kneel at the baptismal font. Is it okay if I scoot in here? It's okay, because we're going to have you laying on hands. Ready? Yeah. Put your hands on Parker. Guys, reach out. Bless him. You're blessing him, so you're making sure that you're praying over each person. Oh God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted Parker into the faith and family through the waters of baptism. May you daily increase in your Holy Spirit as he continues to grow in his faith and love, serving God in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Parker in the gift of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth and to inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that he has been moved to affirm his baptism. Help him live not for himself, but for Christ and those who Christ loves. Keep him steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, and pressing toward the goal of life with you in Jesus Christ, we pray. And the people say, Amen. Amen. All right, you may stand. Allie, are you next? If you are family or friends of Allie Endries, I invite you to come forward. Got to make sure all your people get here. God of grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted Allie into the faith and family through the waters of baptism. May you daily increase your Holy Spirit as she continues to grow in her faith and love, serving you in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Allie and the gift of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth and to inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that she has been moved to affirm her baptism. Help her live not for herself, but for Christ and those who Christ loves. Keep her steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, and pressing toward the goal of life with you in Jesus Christ, we pray. And the people say, Amen. All right. It's your turn, Mr. Weston. All right, Weston Healer's family and friends. We want to make sure Grandpa and everybody gets up here. There is some love. You are their legacy. Let her get on in there. Oh God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted Weston into the faith and family of the waters of baptism. May you daily increase your Holy Spirit as he continues to grow in his faith and love, serving you in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Weston in the gifts of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth and inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that he has been moved to affirm his baptism. Help him live not for himself, but for Christ and for those who Christ loves. Keep him steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, and pressing on toward the goal of life with you in Jesus Christ, we pray. And the people say,
Amen. Good job. All right, who's next? Molly. Ooh, here we go. If you are family of Molly, please come forward. Ready? We're going to give them all a moment, okay? We've got a whole section coming. There's room over here. There's room. There's room. Come on in. Are you ready? All right. Oh God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted Molly into the faith and family through the waters of baptism. May you daily increase your spirit as she continues to grow in her faith and love, serving you in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Molly in the gift of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth and to inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that she has moved to affirm her baptism. Help her live not for herself, but for Christ and those who Christ loves. Keep her steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, and pressing toward the goal of life with you. In Jesus Christ we pray. And the people say, Amen. Is it? Who's next? Annie. If you are family of Annie Lee Puro, come bless her. Ready? O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted Andy into the faith and family through the waters of baptism. May you daily increase in your Holy Spirit as she continues to grow in her faith and love, serving you in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Annie in the gift of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth and inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that she has been moved to affirm her baptism. Help her live not for herself, but for Christ and for those who Christ loves. Keep her steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, pressing toward the goal of life with you. In Jesus Christ, we pray, and the people say, Amen. Amen. Is it Mr. Owen? Is the family of Owen please come forward? And friends, come on down. Come on in. Ready? O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted Owen into the faith and family through the waters of baptism. May you daily increase in your Holy Spirit as he continues to grow in his faith and love, serving you in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Owen in the gift of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth and to inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that he has been moved to affirm his baptism. Help him live not for himself, but for Christ and those who Christ loves. Keep him steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, and pressing toward the goal of life with you. In Jesus Christ we pray. And the people say, Amen. Amen. Is it Mr. Maverick next?
Will the family and friends of Maverick please come forward? It's covered. No swirlies. You're okay. Come close. Let's get the grandparents and everybody in here tight. Come close. Ready? Are you ready? Okay. Oh God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you've accepted Maverick into the faith and family through the waters of baptism. May you daily increase your Holy Spirit as he continues to grow in his faith and love, serving you in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Maverick in the gift of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth and inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that he has been moved to affirm his baptism. Help him live not for himself, but for Christ and those who Christ loves. Keep him steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, and pressing toward the goal of life with you. In Jesus Christ we pray, and the people say,
Amen.
Amen. Emma. Will the family and friends of Emma please come forward? I was going to say, where do you want to... To say, Grandma, Grandpa, come on the side. There's room. There's like space. All right, you ready? Oh God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted Emma into the faith and family through the waters of baptism. May you daily increase your Holy Spirit as she continues to grow in her faith and love, serving you in the world. We rejoice, O God, with Emma in the gift of the Holy Spirit to awaken us to new truth, inspire us to venture into the fullness of life. We give thanks that she has been moved to affirm her baptism. Help her to live not for herself, but for Christ and those who Christ loves. Keep her steady, abounding in hope, never giving up, and pressing toward the goal of life with you. In Jesus Christ we pray, and the people say, Amen. Amen. Is she the last one? All right, so I'll have our confirmands stand forward, and we have gifts for each of them. We have one more part to do. I almost forgot. I invite the congregation to please stand and affirm our ministry in Jesus Christ that's written in the bulletin. We promise you our continuing friendship and prayers as we share in the hopes and labors of the Church of Jesus Christ. By the power of the Holy Spirit, may we continue to grow together in God's knowledge and love and to be witnesses of our risen Savior. You may be seated. On behalf of St. Peter's United Church of Christ, welcome as official voting members of the church. So we have gifts for each of you. Fitz, would you mind helping hand out? So you've got in here, there's a letter that comes from our conference minister, Franz, as he congratulates you on your confirmation. You have your certificate that says you are confirmed. You have your offering envelopes, because that's what you do when you're a member of the church, right? And then you've got a gift for me that you'll be using in the future as we continue to grow in our faith. Congregation, I hope you'll all give them a warm welcome. Would you please join me in clapping and welcoming them? This way. You may be seated. Would you stand and join me as we sing Born in Cry number 680 in your hymnals? United Church of Christ practices an open communion. We believe that this is Christ's table. All who wish to know Christ are welcome at the table. There is gluten-free bread in this small container in the center, and if you need or want grape juice, that is the center ring in every tray. We come to this table in covenant with God and one another. We are still learning what covenant and healthy relationships mean, how it looks and moves and feels, because we long to be the church, living into a faith where we are all one. We recognize that this is not the table of the United Church of Christ, it is Christ's table, and you are invited to bring your whole lives. All are welcome here. The Holy One be with you.
And also with you.
Open your hearts to the one who is love. Let us give thanks to God who gives us courage.
To the one who calls us to lives of service, we give thanks and grace.
We remember that on the night Jesus was arrested, Jesus gathered people to eat a meal together. Jesus took the bread, blessed it, and shared it, saying, "Take and eat. This is the bread of life. Do this in remembrance of me." That same way, Jesus took the cup after supper, blessed it, poured it, and shared it, said, "This is the cup of the new covenant. Share it and remember." And so we do. We remember, we offer, and we receive. Please pray with me. Holy Spirit, bless these simple elements that they may be a visible reminder of your life-saving grace. May they help nourish our bodies, reminding us that we need you and one another. By your Spirit, make us one in Christ with one another. Through Jesus Christ and the love of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Come, all things are ready. This is You have given us peace and blessed us with a taste of your kingdom come. May we continue to bear witness to your steadfast presence among us. In the spirit of the living God, amen.
We witness to our resurrected Jesus in the ways that we lead our lives. Jesus' example for us was to serve one another faithfully. As we give our time, talents, and treasures, whether in this place, as you entered this space, automatically, or go online, we continue to build God's kingdom. Let us stand and offer our thanks and praise as we sing the doxology. Bless these gifts, O Lord, that we share as worship to you with great joy. Please use them to continue serving your people with great love. Use our time and talents in service to you, that we might be the body of Christ at work in the world. Amen. So before we do the Alleluia benediction, I'm going to invite our confirmands to join me in front so that you can greet people afterward with me so that we don't end up bottlenecking everything up too badly. That's the hope, all right? Stand. Ready? So we do an Alleluia benediction, meaning that we sing and the words are Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Do you have the words now? Alleluia. The first time through we sing it. The second time through, we hum as I say a benediction, but we sing a final Alleluia together. All right? Okay. Good. Do to no one evil for evil. Sit with the hurting. Work for God's justice. Honor everyone. Love and serve God, rejoicing in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And may the blessing of God among you, Creator, Emmanuel, and Sustainer be with you now and forevermore.